where the cold hard salt current flows, and this is where they get their name from. This current is rich in fish, which is what the penguins would feed on in the wild. They feed on small fish such as anchovies and squid. Anchovies and sardines, but they also eat squid. And here at the park we see these smelly little scraps which are really nice. They're going mad for them. When it comes to breeding, these guys lay between 1 to 2 large white eggs, and they incubate them for between 39 to 42 days. Those parents take it in turns to incubate the eggs, and they both help them to chick when it is hatched. They normally help the chick out for about 3 months, until it's lost all its downy coat, and it's developed its own waterproof feathers, and then it starts going into the water to learn how to swim and also how to fish. You might have spotted that all the penguins sort of actually looking really tacky and bald in places. Don't worry, this is completely normal for the time of the year. They're actually undergoing molting. So what they're using both layers of their feathers, basically new sets for next season, basically. And we're expecting that they will look nice and smart again at the end of August. This guy here with the bluish and yellow tiger flippers, he's actually fully got new feathers now, so he's looking really smart. This is why we didn't want to actually come in the pool earlier, because they're a bit cold and a bit, they don't really fancy going for a swim, but it does help the process if they go into the water. Unfortunately, these guys are listed as vulnerable in the wild, and they do face several threats, such as oil pollution, long-line fishing nets, and they've got all the systems, but their main threat is actually habitat destruction. It's something called guano harvesting. Does anyone know what the word guano means? If anyone knows, you can shout it out.
No!
That's basically a possible to solve. And the penguins use their own guano to help build their nests and to make them nice and strong. However, the farmers of South America have discovered that guano is a really good fertilizer for their crops. So what they do is they come along and take away all the penguins' guano, forcing the penguins to make their nests without. And this doesn't make them as strong as they would be, normally. So the eggs would be more vulnerable to any predators that may be lurking, and it actually makes the penguins less inclined to even lay eggs in the first place. It also affects the population of penguins in the wild. However, it isn't all doom and gloom. They do very well in captivity.